Boeing E3 Sentry. The Boeing E3 Sentry, commonly known as AWACS, is an American Airborne Early Warning and Control, ANC, aircraft developed by Boeing. Derived from the Boeing 707, it provides all-weather surveillance, command, control, and communications, and is used by the United States Air Force, NATO, Royal Air Force, French Air Force, and Royal Saudi Air Force. The E3 is distinguished by the distinctive rotating radar dome above the fuselage. Production ended in 1992 after 68 aircraft had been built. In the mid-1960s, the U.S. Air Force, USAF, was seeking an aircraft to replace its piston-engine Lockheed EC-121 Warning Star, which had been in service for over a decade. After issuing preliminary development contracts to three companies, the USAF picked Boeing to construct two airframes to test Westinghouse Electric and Hughes's competing radars. Both radars used pulse Doppler technology, with Westinghouse's design emerging as the contract winner. Testing on the first production E3 began in October 1975. The first USAF E3 was delivered in March 1977, and during the next 7 years, a total of 34 aircraft were manufactured. NATO, as a single entity, also had 18 aircraft manufactured, facing them in Germany. The E3 was also sold to the United Kingdom, 7, and France, 4, and Saudi Arabia, 5, plus 83 derived tanker aircraft. In 1991, when the last aircraft had been delivered, E3s participated in Operation Desert Storm, playing a crucial role of directing coalition aircraft against the enemy. Throughout the aircraft's service life, numerous upgrades were performed to enhance its capabilities. In 1996, Westinghouse Electric's Defense and Electronic Systems Division was acquired by Northrop Corporation, before being renamed Northrop Grumman Mission Systems, which currently supports the E3's radar. In 1963, the USAF asked for proposals for an airborne warning and control system, AWACS, to replace its EC-121 Warning Stars, which had served in the airborne early warning role for over a decade. The new aircraft would take advantage of improvements in radar technology and in computer-aided radar data analysis and data reduction. These developments allowed airborne radars to look down, detect the movement of low-flying aircraft, see look down/shoot down, and discriminate, even over land, target aircraft's movements. Previously, this had been impossible, due to the inability to discriminate an aircraft's track from ground clutter. Contracts were issued to Boeing, Douglas, and Lockheed, the latter being eliminated in July 1966. In 1967, a parallel program was put into place to develop the radar, with Westinghouse Electric and Hughes Aircraft being asked to compete in producing the radar system. In 1968, it was referred to as Overland Radar Technology, ORT, during development tests on the modified EC-121Q. The Westinghouse radar antenna was going to be used by whichever company won the radar competition, since Westinghouse had pioneered in the design of high-power RF phase shifters. Boeing initially proposed a purpose-built aircraft, but tests indicated it would not outperform the already operational 707, so the latter was chosen instead. To increase endurance, this design was to be powered by 8 General Electric TF-34s. It would carry its radar in a rotating dome mounted at the top of a forward swept tail, above the fuselage. Boeing was selected ahead of McDonnell Douglas's DC-8-based proposal in July 1970. Initial orders were placed for two aircraft, designated EC-137D as testbeds to evaluate the two competing radars. As the testbeds did not need the same 14-hour endurance demanded of the production aircraft, the EC-137s retained the Pratt & Whitney GE3D commercial engines, and a later reduction in endurance requirement led to retaining the normal engines in production. The first EC-137 made its maiden flight on February 9, 1972, with the fly-off between the two radars taking place during March to July that year. Favorable test results led to the selection of Westinghouse's radar for the production aircraft. Hughes's radar was initially thought to be a certain winner, simply because much of its design was also going into the new F-15 Eagles radar program. The Westinghouse radar used a pipelined fast Fourier transform, FFT, to digitally resolve 128 Doppler frequencies, while Hughes's radars used analog filters based on the design for the F-15 fighter. Westinghouse's engineering team won this competition by using a programmable 18-bit computer whose software could be modified before each mission. This computer was the N/EK8 design from the B-57G program, and designated DEC 8EP1 for its much expanded memory. This radar also multiplexed a Beyond the Horizon (VTH) pulse mode that could complement the pulse Doppler radar mode. This proved to be beneficial, especially when the VTH mod is used to detect ships at sea when the radar beam is directed below the horizon. Approval was given on January 26, 1973 for full-scale development of the AWACS system. To allow further development of the aircraft systems, orders were placed for 3 pre-production aircraft, the first of which performed its maiden flight in February 1975. To save costs, the endurance requirements were relaxed, allowing the new aircraft to retain the 4 JT-3D U.S. military designation TF-33 engines. IBM and Hazeltine were selected to develop the mission computer and display system. The IBM computer was designated 4PI, and the software is written in Jovial. A semi-automatic ground environment, SAGE, or backup interceptor control, BUIC, operator would immediately be at home with the track displays and tabular displays, but differences in symbology would create compatibility problems in tactical ground radar systems in Iceland, mainland Europe, and South Korea over Link 11. Delay. Modifications to the Boeing 707 for the E-3 Sentry included a rotating radar dome, rotodome, uprated hydraulics, from 3,500 to 5,000 psi, to drive the rotodome, single-point ground refueling, air refueling, and a bailout tunnel or chute. The original design had 2, one forward, and one aft, but the aft bailout chute was deleted to cut mounting costs. Engineering, test and evaluation began on the first E-3 Sentry in October 1975. Between 1977 and 1992, a total of 60 E-3s were built. Because the Boeing 707 is no longer in production, the E-3 mission package has been fitted into the Boeing E-767 for the Japan Air Self-Defense Forces. The E-10 MC-2A was intended to replace USAF E-3s, along with the RC-135 and the E-8. But the E-10 program was cancelled by the Department of Defense. The USAF is now performing a series of incremental improvements, mainly to avionics, to bring the E-3 up to current standards of performance. Boeing is flight testing its Block 4045 E-3s. This modified E-3 contains upgrades of the mission crew and air battle management sections, as well as significantly upgraded electronics equipment. Another program that the Air Force is considering is the Avionics Modernization Program, AMP. AMP would equip the E-3s with glass cockpits. The Air Force also wants modified E-3s with jet engines that are more reliable than the original ones, and also with at least 19% higher fuel efficiencies. New turbofan engines would give these E-3s longer ranges, longer time on station, and a shorter critical runway length. If the modification is carried out, the E-3s could take off with full fuel loads using runways only long, and also at higher ambient temperatures and lower barometric pressures, such as from bases in mountainous areas. Now that the E-8 Joint Stars are being fitted with the new Pratt & Whitney JT8D219 turbofans, which are stated as having one-half the cost of the competing engine, the CFM56, the Air Force is again studying the possibility of replacing the E-3's original turbofan engines with more efficient ones. Upgrading NATO's E-3 fleet is complicated by the heterogeneity of the fleet's equipment. Each NATO member's E-3 aircraft are configured differently, and NATO has not finalized upgrade or replacement plans. The airplanes themselves can be flown to 2050 with appropriate maintenance, but as the worldwide fleet of 707 aircraft dwindles, supporting the E-3 becomes more difficult. The E-3 Sentry's airframe is a modified Boeing 707-320B advanced model. USAF and NATO E-3s have an unrefueled range of some or 8 hours of flying. The newer E-3 versions bought by France, Saudi Arabia, and the UK are equipped with newer CFM56 2 turbofan engines, and these can fly for about 11 hours or about. The Sentry's range and on-station time can be increased through air-to-air refueling, and the crews can work in shifts by the use of an onboard crew rest and meals area. When deployed, the E-3 monitors an assigned area of the battlefield and provides information for commanders of air operations to gain and maintain control of the battle. While as an air defense asset, E-3s can detect, identify, and track airborne enemy forces far from the boundaries of the U.S. or NATO countries and can direct fighter interceptor aircraft to these targets. In support of air-to-ground operations, the E-3 can provide direct information needed for interdiction, reconnaissance, airlift, and close air support for friendly ground forces. The unpressurized rotodome is 30 feet, 9.1 meters, in diameter, 6 feet, 1.8 meters, thick at the center, and is held 11 feet, 3.4 meters, above the fuselage by two struts. It is tilted down at the front to reduce its aerodynamic drag, which lessens its detrimental effect on takeoffs and endurance, which is corrected electronically by both the radar and secondary surveillance radar antenna phase shifters. The rotodome uses bleed air, outside cooling doors, and fluorocarbon-based cold plate cooling to maintain the electronic and mechanical equipment temperatures. The hydraulically rotated antenna system permits the Westinghouse Corporation's NN/APY2 passive electronically scanned array radar system to provide surveillance from the Earth's surface up into the stratosphere, over land or water. Other major subsystems in the E3 Sentry are navigation, communications, and computers. 14 consoles display computer process data in graphic and tabular format and video screens. Console operators perform surveillance, identification, weapons control, battle management and communications functions. The radar and computer subsystems on the E3 can gather and present broad and detailed battlefield information. This includes position and tracking information on enemy aircraft and ships, and location and status of friendly aircraft and naval vessels. The information can be sent to major command and control centers in rear areas or aboard ships. In times of crisis, data can be forwarded to the National Command Authority in the U.S. via RC-135 or Naval Aircraft Carrier Task Forces. Electrical generators mounted on each of the E3's four engines provide the 1 megawatt of electrical power that is required by the E3's radars and other electronics. Its Pulse Doppler Radar, PD, has a range of more than 250 miles. 400 kilometers, for low-flying targets at its operating altitude, and the Pulse, BTH, radar has a range of approximately 400 miles 650 kilometers, for aircraft flying at medium to high altitudes. The radar, combined with an secondary surveillance radar, SSR, and electronic support measures, ESM, provides a look-down capability, to detect, identify, and track low-flying aircraft, while eliminating ground clutter. Radar returns. Starting in 1987, USAF E3s were upgraded under the Block 3035 modification program to enhance the E3's capabilities. On October 30, 2001, the final airframe to be upgraded under this program was rolled out. Several major enhancements were made, firstly the installation of ESM and an electronic surveillance capability, for both active and passive means of detection. Also, Joint Tactical Information Distribution System, JTIDS, was installed, which provides rapid and secure communication for transmitting information, including target positions and identification data, to other friendly platforms. Global Positioning System, GPS, capability was also added. Onboard computers were also overhauled to accommodate JTIDS, Link 16, the new ESM systems and to provide for future enhancements. The Radar System Improvement Program, RSIP, was a joint U.S.-NATO development program. RSIP enhances the operational capability of the E3 radar's electronic countermeasures, and dramatically improves the system's reliability, maintainability, and availability. Essentially, this program replaced the older transistor-transistor logic, TTL, and emitter-coupled logic, MECL, electronic components, long since out of production, with off-the-shelf digital computers that utilized a high-level programming language instead of assembly language. Significant improvement came from adding pulse compression to the pulse Doppler mode, replacing the old 8-bit FFT with 24-bit FFTs, and the 12-bit AD, sine plus 12 bits, with all 15-bit AD, sine plus 15 bits. These hardware and software modifications improve the E3 radar's performance, providing enhanced detection with an emphasis towards low radar cross-section, RCS, targets. The RAF had also joined the USAF in adding RSIP to upgrade the E3's radars. The retrofitting of the E3 squadrons was completed in December 2000. Along with the RSIP upgrade was installation of the Global Positioning System/Inertial Navigation Systems, which dramatically improved positioning accuracy. In 2002, Boeing was awarded a contract to add RSIP to the small French AWACS squadron. Installation was completed in 2006. In 2009, the USAF, in cooperation with NATO, entered into a major flight deck avionics modernization program in order to maintain compliance with worldwide airspace mandates. The program, called Dragon, for DM's replacement of avionics for global operation and navigation, was awarded in 2010. The prime was Boeing and the subcontractor was Rockwell Collins. Drawing on their flight-to-flight management system, FMS, almost all the existing avionics were replaced with new, more modern digital equipment from Rockwell Collins. The major upgraded capabilities include a digital audio distribution system, Mode 5/ADS-B transponder, Inmarsat and VDL data links, and a TAS function. The navigation system is capable of RNP 0.3, STARS and LNAV/NAV approaches, and SIDS. The centerpiece flight deck hardware consists of 5 6x8 color graphics displays, 2 PFDs, 2 AMFDs, and an ICAS, 2 color CDUs, and a Thales ISD standby. Dragon lays the foundation for subsequent upgrades including GPS M-Code, Iridium ATC, and Autopilot. USAF Dragon production begins in 2018. In March 1977, the 552nd Airborne Warning and Control Wing, now the 552D Air Control Wing, at Tinker AFB, Oklahoma received the first T-3 aircraft, flown and commanded by Major James R. Stirk. The 34th and last USAF Sentry was delivered in June 1984. In March 1996, the USAF activated the 513th Air Control Group, 513 ACG, and ACC Gain Air Force Reserve Command, AFRC, AWACS unit under the Reserve Associate Program. Collocated with the 552 ACW at Tinker AFB, the 513 ACG, which performs similar duties on active duty E-3 aircraft, shared with the 552 ACW. The USAF has a total of 31 E-3s in active service. 27 are stationed at Tinker AFB and belong to the Air Combat Command, ACC. 4 are assigned to the Pacific Air Forces, PACAF, and stationed at Kadena AB, Okinawa and Elmendorf AFB, Alaska. 1 aircraft, TS-3, was assigned to Boeing for testing and development, retired/scrapped June 2012. In 1977, Iran placed an order for 10 E-3s, however this order was cancelled following the 1979 revolution. NATO acquired 18 E-3s and support equipment for a NATO air defense force. Since all aircraft must be registered with a certain country, the decision was made to register the 18 NATO sentries with Luxembourg, a NATO member that previously did not have any air force. The first NATO E-3 was delivered in January 1982. The 18 E-3s were operated by No. 1, 2 and 3 squadrons of NATO's E-3 component, based at NATO Air Base Geilenkirchen. Presently, 16 NATO E-3s are in the inventory, since one E-3 was lost in a crash and one was retired from service in 2015, see below. The United Kingdom and France are not part of the NATO E-3A component, instead procuring E-3 aircraft through a joint project. The UK and France operate their E-3 aircraft independently of each other and of NATO. The UK operates 6 aircraft, with a 7th now retired, and France operates 4 aircraft, all fitted with the newer CFM56-2 engines. The British requirement came about following the cancellation of the British Aerospace Nimrod A3 project to replace the Avro Shackleton A2 during the 1980s. The UK E3 order was placed in February 1987, with deliveries starting in 1990. The other operator of the type, delivered between June 1986 and September 1987, is Saudi Arabia, which operates 5 aircraft, all fitted with CFM56-2 engines. This particular sale was hotly contested between the Reagan administration and opponents of the sale, mainly the Israeli lobby in the United States and their allies in Congress. E-3 Sentry aircraft were among the first to deploy during Operation Desert Shield, where they immediately established as an around-the-clock radar screen to defend against Iraqi forces. During Operation Desert Storm, E-3s flew 379 missions and logged 5,052 hours of on-station time. The data collection capability of the E-3 radar and computer subsystems allowed an entire air war to be recorded for the first time in history. In addition to providing senior leadership with time-critical information on the actions of enemy forces, E-3 controllers assisted in 38 of the 41 air-to-air kills recorded during the conflict. NATO E-3s joined their USAF colleagues for joint air defense as part of Operation Eagle Assist in the wake of the September 11, 2001 terrorist attacks on the World Trade Center towers and the Pentagon. NATO and RAF E-3s participated in the international military operation in Libya. On January 27, 2015, the RAF deployed an E-3D Sentry to Cyprus in support of U.S.-led coalition airstrikes against Islamic State militants in Iraq and Syria. The Sentry joins RAF Panavia Tornado, MQ-9 Reaper, and air tanker Voyager aircraft performing or supporting almost daily strikes against militants. On June 23, 2015, the first of the original 18 NATO E-3A AWACS aircraft to retire arrived at Davis Monthan AFB near Tucson, Arizona. The aircraft, LXN-90449, will be placed in parts reclamation storage where critical parts will be removed by NATO technicians to support their remaining fleet of 16 Boeing E-3A aircraft. It had accumulated 22,206 flight hours between August 19, 1983 and May 13, 2015 and operated out of 21 different countries in support of NATO operational activities. The aircraft was due in mid-July 2015 for a six-year cycle depot level maintenance, DLM, inspection, which would have been very costly. Without the inspection, the aircraft would no longer be allowed to fly. The so-called 449 retirement project will result in reclamation of critical parts with a value of upwards of $40 million. Some of the parts to be removed are no longer on the market or have become very expensive. On November 18, 2015, an E-3G was deployed to the Middle East to begin immediately flying combat missions in support of Operation Inherent Resolve against ISIL, marking the first combat deployment of the upgraded AWACS Block 4045. The $2.7 billion development effort started in 2003, with the first five aircraft achieving initial operational capability, IOC, in July 2015. The Block 4045 upgrade is the most extensive the E-3 has undergone, replacing its 1970s computer technology with an early 2000s standard and including a deployable ground system that receives, processes, and disseminates data. The Air Force plans to convert 24 AWACS to E-3G standard, while retiring 7 from the fleet to avoid upgrade costs and harvest out of production components. The E-3 has been involved in 3 hull loss accidents, and 1 radar antenna destroyed during RSUP development, see photo under avionics. Notes, citations, bibliography. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.